Good evening, Hong Kongers. In the past half year, the Hong Kong police have wildly fired over 10,000 tear gas canisters all over 17 districts of Hong Kong, affecting all areas, including indoor areas, residential areas, and community facilities. Never before has the world seen such concentrated and continuous firing of tear gas in a place like Hong Kong, the third most densely populated place in the world. The Hong Kong regime's refusal to address leftover toxins in the community, despite the surfacing of many cases of Hong Kongers suffering all sorts of conditions after exposure of tear gas, is responsible for an incalculable damage to the health of Hong Kongers. The regime's force give no regard to the life of Hong Kongers in deploying made-in-China tear gas canisters en masse. Meanwhile, the regime refuses to release the chemical compositions of the toxic tear gas and its leftovers, making it difficult for doctors to treat patients. All these points to the necessity of more follow-up research on tear gas. In view of this issue, the Citizen Press Conference team conducted an online survey for 72 hours from 10 a.m. 29th of November to 10 a.m. 2nd of December, managing to collect over 17,000 responses, representing the largest citizen-led survey-based research on tear gas conducted in Hong Kong so far. Due to Hong Kongers being directly and indirectly exposed to tear gas in the past few months, the question of tear gas's effect on exposed body parts and on non-exposed body parts has become a pressing matter, yet remains unanswered. From our analysis of the research, of the research data, the Citizen Press Conference team had obtained the following conclusions. First, results indicate that the tear gas fired by Hong Kong police force mostly impact respiratory tract, eyes and skin. 18 to 23% of respondents suffered from difficulty breathing, watery eyes for an abnormally long period, and skin irritation. Figures similar to data from studies overseas. However, up to 14 to 16% of our respondents suffer from abdominal pain and diarrhea, an incidence rate of over 3 times higher than figures presented by studies overseas. Symptoms such as blood and cough, dysentery and discoloured urine have also been reported, all of which are symptoms seldom seen in past tear gas studies. This prompts concern of the potential toxicity of tear gas smoke deployed by the Hong Kong police on human body, potentially connected with the dangerous levels of cyanide measured on multiple occasions by HKGETV. Medical journals and reports have pointed out that inhalation of excessive amounts of cyanide may lead to symptoms and diarrhea. Second, results indicate that a number of respondents suffered skin reactions and permanent scars from tear gas exposure. Nearly 17% of respondents, up to 3,000 individuals, suffered symptoms such as rashes, blisters, and even abscess. We have compiled a color-coded body diagram of those who have suffered from skin reactions from tear gas exposure. 90% report reactions on the areas are indicated in red, 80% reported are indicated in orange, and 70% reported are indicated in yellow. Based on this diagram, rashes appear mostly on the face and arms, while blisters form mostly on the face, forearms and feet, and abscesses form mostly on the head and back shoulders. Third, the closer one remains in contact with tear smoke, the more worrying his or her situation is. Our survey collected data regarding respondents' roles in protests, such as being a frontline protester, a pacifist protester, an online professional, such as first aiders, reporters, and even police officers. Those active on protest front lines have been in direct exposure to tear gas displays and incidence rates, 20% for various symptoms, nearly twice as high compared to an incidence of around 10% for respondents further away from protest front lines, including pacifist protesters and passerby. This city-wide gas chamber created by the Hong Kong police force has paved the way for its mutual destruction along with all other Hong Kongers. Earlier, a Stan News reporter publicly demonstrated the chloregne, and explained that it is an indicator of high levels of toxin residing in his body. Undoubtedly, toxic tear gas must have been the cause. All frontliners should caution at a high risk that tear gas exposes them to, even if they are fully equipped. Meanwhile, Sophia Chan, Secretary of Food and Health, continues to refuse to release the chemical composition of police forces' tear gas, stating that reveling the force, its composition would somehow affect the force's strategic planning. Such statements only fuel speculation on what poisons could their tear gas be composed of, and why are they afraid of releasing it to the public. Fourthly, the impacts of tear gas are everywhere. Our research collected data about the districts which respondents had directly or indirectly inhaled tear gas particles and whether the inhalation took place while at home, at work, or en route to work. From our results, the districts most affected by tear gas poison are Sham Shui Po and Tai Po, followed by Yao Qin Wang and Kun Tong, in turn followed by Wong Tai Sin and Yun Long, all of which are districts with large amounts of residential areas. In particular, Sham Shui Po is very densely populated, housing over 43,000 people per square kilometer. Since June, not only has Hong Kong police force suppressed ever-expanding powers and taking to abuse violence, it has taken a liking to runaway firing of tear gas in the 18 districts of Hong Kong, firing hundreds of canisters at time. Even if residents do not leave their home, tear gas still finds its way to the place, and they are not spared from being affected by tear gas. The police force repeatedly violating instructions and ethical codes of conduct, firing tear gas into densely populated and closed-off areas, forming an unholy alliance with Hong Kong's high-rise building that further trap these poisonous gas, have turned Hong Kong's neighborhood into a well of leftover toxins and chemicals, turning our homeland into a citywide gas chamber. Refusing to adequately address leftover toxins in community facilities, the Hong Kong regime is openly tolerating a poisoning of an entire generation of Hong Kongers. Their cold-bloodedness, incredulous, instead of fixing problems, high-ranking officials only know how to whitewash, hoping to talk the problem away. Earlier, Lord Chi Kwong, Secretary of Labour and Welfare, even tried to downplay the toxicity being released by the police force, claiming that a family barbecue would emit more dioxin than tear gas fired by the police force. Such absurdity not only insults the Legislative Council chamber from which he was speaking from, it insults the intelligence of all Hong Kongers. Our city is already tainted by more than 10,000 fired tear gas. Everyone knows that the residue will not be dissolved shortly. Instead, they are going to affect generations to come. Facing the Hong Kong puppet government's blatant attempt to terrify and crush us with brutality and toxic gas, the citizen press conference pledged to the government and authorities around the world to identify this as a humanitarian crisis and should impose sanctions to all those who are harming us politically and physically. On top of that, we urge the Hong Kong government to stop deploying toxic gas immediately in future operations. Not only will this deepen your sins to the people, it will also further ignite our determination to prevail. Thank you very much.